Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I'm going to show you what to do when the text panel is not allowing you to make any edits to your timeline. Okay, so this is a pretty regular problem that I hear about on the forums, and there are usually two common solutions to this issue. And the first is incredibly easy. So you can see here I've got the text panel, I've got my audio loaded in the sequence, and over here, if I want to select some text, it's not actually selecting it in my timeline. If I press delete, it's not going to delete it in my timeline. And also, if I go up to my filter icon and filter on pauses, you'll notice that the delete button is actually grayed out. So it's not letting me make any changes to the audio in my timeline. This is because of a very simple issue, and that is that I have this same file that's in my timeline. I have it loaded in my source monitor. And if I go back over to my text panel, down here you can see that I have follow active monitor ticked, and it's currently following that audio in my source monitor. So I can't make any edits in my source monitor, so that's why it's actually stopping me from doing that here. So the very simple solution is to just go over to my timeline and select it here, and then go back to my text panel. You'll see now that the timeline monitor is the active monitor, and you can see now the delete button is enabled. I can click delete and delete all of those pauses from my timeline. So that's a very simple solution for solution number one. The other one requires just a little bit more of an explanation. If I go over to solution two here, you can see I've got my text loaded in the text panel here, and if I go up and filter on pauses, I get the same thing. It's highlighting all of those pauses here, but the delete button is grayed out. And this is actually because the transcript that I'm working with here is what's known as a static transcript, which means the clip in my timeline and the transcript of the sequence are two separate things. And I could actually make changes to the clip in my timeline and it won't be reflected here in this static transcript. And the number one giveaway that you're working with a static transcript is to go up to the top right of the text panel and click these three dots. And if it says generate text-based editing transcript, that means you're working with a static transcript. Static transcripts do not support text-based editing. Very, very simple solution. All I need to do is then click generate text-based editing transcript. I'm going to go down here and click continue, and it will retranscribe those files in my timeline and make them source-based transcripts rather than sequence-based transcripts. And now I go back here, I can see my delete button is enabled. I can click delete, delete all, and those changes are reflected in my timeline. So that just means that next time you go to transcribe any of your media, the best thing to do is to go over to your project panel, select the media that you want to transcribe, and then click the transcribe button. In this case, it says retranscribe, but if I hadn't transcribed it before, it would say transcribe. And that just means it's going to make sure that it's a text-based editing transcript rather than a static transcript. Anyway, I hope you found this useful. If you did, please remember to like and subscribe, and if you got the time, maybe check out some of these other videos.